Are you wondering what it's like to live in the Puerto Madero neighborhood of Buenos Aires? Well, I lived there for almost 2 years, and I'll tell you everything you need to know. Hi friends, welcome back to the channel. This week, I'm gonna tell you all about one of my favorite neighborhoods in Buenos Aires, and that is Puerto Madero. And I know Puerto Madero can get a little bit of a bad name sometimes. I feel like it can get very polarizing. There's people that love it and there's people that hate the neighborhood. But I'm going to break down the ins and outs for you because I actually lived there and I have an opinion on it as well. Guys, before we get into the video, I wanted to ask you to go below and give me a thumbs up and also a subscribe. I am trying really hard to get to 1,000 subscribers by November 1st, which is just about 2 weeks away. I need about 150 more subscribers. So please, if you are interested in all things expat life, if you are planning on moving to Buenos Aires when the borders open in a few weeks, then you're definitely gonna wanna subscribe to this channel because I talk about all things Buenos Aires. All right, let's start with a brief history of Puerto Madero. Obviously, by the name, you can tell that it was used as a port starting in about the late 1800s. It is a really good location, central in South America. Obviously, it's really great for Argentina. And where the location, they could bring in the large cargo ships. So it was used as a port for almost 100 years until the late 1990s when the city decided they wanted to urbanize it and just kind of redevelop it for residential, commercial, and just kind of mixed use in general. So there was domestic and also international foreign investment that came in to really make Puerto Madero what it is today. They took a lot of the old shipping warehouses that you can still see today and turned them into really swanky restaurants. Some of them have condos in them as well. And then of course, you'll see the gorgeous high-rise buildings. A lot of people came in and built those in the last 10 to 20 years as well. So Puerto Madero, from what it used to look like, literally just a swamp with a port, has now become this over-the-top, lots of buildings, lots of places to live, shop, and eat. And it's really just a beautiful place to live in general. So let's just talk about the overall neighborhood vibe of Puerto Madero. So when you're in Puerto Madero, you kind of feel like you're almost in a completely different city sometimes, even though you're actually really close to the city center. You're closer than a lot of neighborhoods. You can easily walk over to the Casa Rosada and the Micro Center. It's not a very far walk at all, 20 minutes tops. So you're actually really in the thick of it when you live in Puerto Madero, but I think because the neighborhood is actually separated by a canal of water and you have to physically cross a bridge either by car or by foot to go into the city, it kind of feels like you can be further away from the city. And also when you cross those bridges into the Puerto Madero neighborhood, you really start to get a different vibe or a different sense. The buildings are much more modern because, like we said, the neighborhood is only about 20 years old. It is much greener. There's a lot more park space because the majority of the area is park space. There's not that many buildings. The buildings that they do have are high rise, so they have a lot of apartments in one building versus just going 10 stories up and having multiple buildings. So it's just more modern, it's quieter, it's greener as well than most of Buenos Aires. So I think that's why it feels very different than the typical Buenos Aires neighborhood. So if you're planning on moving to Buenos Aires and you're watching this video because you want to know about the Puerto Madero neighborhood, you're definitely in the right place. But I will say, if you're looking for more of that traditional type neighborhood, or you want to see that architecture, you know, like on your building or on your next door neighbor's building, then Puerto Madero is not going to be the neighborhood for you. You probably want to stick to some of the neighborhoods on the other side of the canal, which I highly recommend Recoleta. I highly recommend Palermo and Belgrano as well. There's many, many neighborhoods. I only recommend those because that's where I spent most of my time, and I actually lived in Recoleta as well. I'm gonna do another video on Recoleta, so if you're interested in that, then definitely hit that red subscribe button and you'll be notified when it comes out. All right, let's talk about transportation in Puerto Madero. So I hate to lead with bad news, but the public transportation is not very good in Puerto Madero. So the subway, the Supte, does not even go into that neighborhood. You would probably have to get off in the Micro Center at the Casa Rosada, Playa de Mayo, and actually walk over. So I would say that walk to the subway from to the Supte from Puerto Madero is going to be about at least 15-20 minute walk. So the Supte is not very close. There is one bus route that goes along the main street, but again, it doesn't go the entire length of the neighborhood. So it's not the best public transportation neighborhood. I do think if you don't have access to a car or a personal vehicle, it could feel a little bit isolating living in Puerto Madero. It just kind of depends on what you enjoy doing. Personally, I didn't feel isolated, but it was not easy for me to just go around Buenos Aires. If you've watched some of our previous videos, I have shared that we had a car service in Buenos Aires when we lived there. So I could use them whenever I wanted to, but the other thing that you can definitely do if you want to get into the other neighborhoods in Buenos Aires is use taxis. Taxis are super cheap. They're easy to find in all the neighborhoods. So that's going to be your best bet if you don't have a car, but you still want to live in the Puerto Madero neighborhood. Parks and green space in Puerto Madero. This is definitely one of the reasons a lot of people move to that neighborhood. There's so much green space, there's so many parks, there's lots of places to play football, there's so many places for you to put down your blanket and sip some mate, hang out with friends and family, go running, ride your bike, play with your dog, play with your children. There's so many places. The space is incredible, and that is what attracts a lot of people to this neighborhood. And Puerto Madero is also the home of La Reserva Ecológica, and I actually did an entire video on this one, so definitely check it out. But it is a huge area, a reserve that you can use to go jogging, to go walking, to go biking. You can go back there and get closer to the river, Rio de la Plata, and enjoy some meditation or just enjoy the gorgeous view. It is a really, really nice park to spend some time, and you really feel isolated from the city there. You can tell that you are further away, you won't hear any of the road noise, you won't hear any horns honking. It's really a really great place to go whenever you're feeling a little drained from the city and you just want to get out, but maybe you don't want to go on a full weekend trip. You can head over to the park and really just enjoy your time there. So again, I did a whole video on this, so definitely check it out. So if you're looking for a relaxing lifestyle in Buenos Aires or someplace where you can be outdoors a little bit more, or maybe you have pets or small children that you want to give them the opportunity to be outside and run around more, then I definitely recommend the Puerto Madero neighborhood because it's not gonna get any better as far as park space and just quiet and peacefulness in Buenos Aires. Goods and stores in Puerto Madero. So I want to talk just briefly about what kind of stores you can find in the neighborhood. So while you can definitely find everything that you need in Puerto Madero, there might just be fewer options. So there might just be one or two stores available to choose from. So they will definitely have a ferreteria, but there's just one. There's a really good panaderia, but I believe there's just one, maybe two. While other neighborhoods like Recoleta had many, many bakeries to choose from. They're going to have a pharmacy, but there's just a few in the neighborhood. There are, I believe, two veterinarians in the neighborhood. So there is everything that you need. It's just much more limited in options. And not only is it more limited in options, you can probably expect to pay a little bit more for your goods and also for the services in Puerto Madero, because they know that Puerto Madero is a very expensive neighborhood to live in. And they figure if you can afford that rent, or you can afford that mortgage, that home, then you can afford to pay a little bit more on your goods as well. For grocery stores in Puerto Madero, the largest is going to be Jumbo, and it's located on the far end of the neighborhood. So if you live a little bit further, for me, my walk was about 15-20 minutes to the store. They have a delivery service, of course, just like every other grocery store in Buenos Aires. So you can buy a cart full of food and they will deliver it to you usually about 2 to 3 hours later. So it's a great service. So don't worry, there's definitely a grocery store. But for those of you that live in Buenos Aires or you're familiar with Buenos Aires, Jumbo is a very expensive grocery store. It is the most expensive grocery store. It's a chain, and there's a few chains throughout the city. But it is the most expensive grocery store in the city. So again, be prepared for those high prices that you will have to pay in the grocery stores. There are two, maybe three other small grocery stores. They're not a kiosco, but they're not a full-blown grocery store either. They'll have very little produce available. But if you just need some milk, some bread, some cookies, crackers, maybe some bananas, there are some other options that are a little bit closer to some of the residential areas as well. But truly, Jumbo is going to be your only true grocery store with lots of options available in Puerto Madero. Another favorite part of living in Puerto Madero is the weekly farmers market. Now, of course, this happens in, I think, about every neighborhood in Buenos Aires, but I really enjoyed going each Sunday morning. They usually opened, I think, around 8 a.m., and you could go. We would walk our dogs there. We would take our shopping cart with us, and we would fill it up with fruits and vegetables and some beans and chia seeds and sometimes some fish that we would use that produce to cook for the rest of the week. Modern architecture and buildings. Yes, it is true that Puerto Madero, with one glance, you can tell that it is a very modern neighborhood because, like we said earlier, it has only been built in the last 20 years. And I think this is why Puerto Madero sometimes gets a bad name. I think people see it's very modern. Maybe they just spend a couple hours walking the neighborhood and they feel like, I've heard this said a few times, that it's like any other neighborhood in the world. You can find that neighborhood in Singapore or Dubai or any place in the US. And I see where they're coming from as far as the architecture. It is very modern. The buildings are high rise, they're glossy, they're fancy looking. And some of the restaurants are more chain type restaurants. So I do see where they're coming as far as this neighborhood could be in any neighborhood in the world. However, I do think that unless you live there and you actually spend more time than just a few hours, you won't be able to experience all that Puerto Madero has to offer. If you spend some kind of significant time in Puerto Madero, you'll find that it's still like any other neighborhood in Buenos Aires. There's the food trucks that are there all the time and they serve authentic Argentine cuisine, and they're really delicious. There's the typical shops, your panaderias, your ferreterias, where people really get to know the shop owners. The food is super authentic, super delicious. There are still restaurants, there are cafes where you can sit and take a coffee, and enjoy the people watching. So there are some very Argentine qualities about Puerto Madero still, and you will still feel like you're living in Buenos Aires. So I hear a lot of chatter that you won't think you're living in Buenos Aires or it doesn't look like Buenos Aires. Well, I can tell you, after living in Recoleta and also Puerto Madero, you will still feel like you're living in Buenos Aires. You will still be among porteños. There are definitely expats that live in Puerto Madero as well, but there's lots of porteños. There is still lots of culture to be had and enjoyed in Puerto Madero. So let's talk a little bit about the residents in Puerto Madero. In this neighborhood, you will definitely find a lot of expats living there. There are some large multinational corporations that are headquartered in Puerto Madero or in the Micro Center, which is very close, walking distance. And so a lot of those company expats would like to be close to their job so they can easily walk and commute. So that's one reason. Another reason is, again, it's a little bit more modern, so they have some more modern conveniences in the apartments that they've built in the last 10, 15 years. The sidewalks are much wider because it's been built more recently, so I think people have more room to kind of do what they want to do with their baby strollers or their kids on tricycles and that type of thing. So you will find a lot more expats in the neighborhood, but there are still a lot of porteños as well. However, it's no secret that the rents in Puerto Madero are probably some of the highest in the city. So you're going to find a lot of wealthy people in this neighborhood. I cannot tell you how many nice luxury vehicles that I saw driving around when I was walking on the sidewalk. You're going to hear people on the weekends revving up their Ferraris or Lamborghinis or whatever sports car they have. And they just kind of go down and do some loot. So there's definitely a lot of wealth in Puerto Madero, and you will see it when you are living there or visiting as well. So during the weekdays, the parks of Puerto Madero are a lot more quiet because it's just gonna be residents out there walking. There's not a lot of people that will commute into Puerto Madero on a weekday just to go to the park. However, there are a lot of people that commute to Puerto Madero to go to work. So you will find lots and lots of cars kind of lined up down the streets, and those are folks that are going into work, and then they kind of clear out around 6 or 7 p.m. in the evening. On weekends, you can expect to have a lot of partygoers in the late hours. They like to start going to the open air food trucks I talked about, and they like to turn the music up and get some alcohol and get the party going. So you can expect to have those partygoers kind of coming in and enjoying the scene on the weekdays, on the weekends, I mean. So that's gonna be Friday, Saturday, and Sunday night. In fact, Sunday is actually, I think, the loudest night. They really enjoy partying on Sunday nights. And on Saturdays and Sundays, of course, a lot of people from all over Buenos Aires will come in to park their car and really just walk around, do the Sunday stroll, and also just enjoy the parks for themselves as well. So Sundays, Puerto Madero gets pretty plump with people. There's gonna be a lot of people that come in for the day and for the night activities. And then Monday, it kind of feels really quiet again. So it's just a little something to get used to. I kind of think most neighborhoods kind of fill up with people on the weekends, especially the parks, and then things kind of go back to normal on Monday. So that's just something to keep in mind if you decide to live in Puerto Madero. All right, friends. So while I understand Puerto Madero is not for everyone, personally, I really enjoyed living there. It is one of my favorite neighborhoods in Buenos Aires. Yes, it is very modern. It is the most modern neighborhood in the city. However, I promise you, you will still know you're living in Buenos Aires, and the rest of the city is just a short 10-minute car ride away. So don't feel like you won't get the Buenos Aires experience if you're living in Puerto Madero. That is just not true. And if you are seeking a more quiet and more modern way of living when you are in Buenos Aires, then check out Puerto Madero because it could be a good option for you. All right, friends, I hope this description of Puerto Madero has kind of helped open your mind a little bit, has helped explain to you what Puerto Madero is like, give you kind of some insider knowledge from someone that lived there for almost 2 years, and I hope it was really beneficial. Be sure to go below and hit that subscribe button because I'm going to be doing this with the Recoleta neighborhood as well, giving you an insider's perspective, and I'll see you next time. Bye, guys.